Hello everybody, MK502 here, and today I'm here with a trashy tripod again. I'm working on it. And today I'm doing a couple how-to Halloween videos. Videos? It's not plural, it's going into one video. What am I talking about? Anyway, so the first one we're going to do is called a powder bomb. So basically, all you need for this is some glue. Any glue will work. An eggshell that's empty. Clean it out, too. It needs to be clean. A piece of a paper towel, a marker, and some baby powder. Now, the marker isn't necessarily needed. It's just if you want to be that person and... There you go. You got an egg there. But anyway, next part I have to go outside for. So I'll be right back. Okay guys, welcome outside. How do you like my grass? Anyway, so now we're gonna take our egg, we're gonna fill it full of baby powder. This is a messy job. Oh, this is hard. Oh geez. Okay, well, you guys get the gist. Try not to fill it that full. And now I have some white ground going on there. Anyway. Just baby powder, it smells good. So, oh jeez. Stuff's going away from me. So then what you want to do is you want to take this piece of paper towel and glue it over the hole so nothing falls out. So, I'm going to do that quick. I'm also going to wash off this baby powder off my hands. Okay, well, anyway, I'll be right back. Anyway, so there's the finished product. The egg. And it's sealed up at the top so nothing can fall out. And I also have a very white ground right now. So we're going to go to a spot where I can throw this at a wall. I'll see you in the wall. Okay, guys, so we are now out back. And I'm going to throw this powder bomb at the garage. Okay, three, two.
Are you sure they're going to see it?
So, there you go. Nice powder bomb for Halloween.
I don't know that you got it.
I did. Quick disclaimer. If you get in trouble using that, it's not my fault. It's your fault for being stupid with it. Anyway, to our next how-to. Okay, guys, for this next one, I'm just going to call it Hands Out of the Ground. What you'll need are some white or clear latex gloves, a marker, and some sand. And a funnel or trowel or however you want to get the sand into a glove is your choice. I'm gonna just use a funnel and pour it in there. So we will now go outside, fill the glove full of sand, and then I'm gonna have my mom draw some bones on there. We will be right back. Okay, we are now back outside and we're going to fill the latex glove full of sand. So if you're gonna do it this method, what I do is I hold the funnel on the latex glove, I hold it shut. And usually I scoop it in there, but I'm just gonna pour it in for now, and let's see if this is enough. And the glove will start filling with sand, and hopefully this is enough. That was not enough sand. I have to go get more sand. Be right back. There's the finished product for the glove. Now I'm gonna get some rocks and I'm gonna put it around it and it's gonna look really cool. But now this next part is gonna be like magic. I'm gonna cover the lens and there's magically gonna be five of these gloves in front of you. Just wait and see. I told you guys this is gonna be magic. Ba-ba-da-da! Five! Well, you know what? Six, because we just did one. Okay, so now we're gonna go grab some rocks, and we'll get on with the end result.
Let me look at it.
Hey guys, here's a finished product. Looks pretty cool. And if you want to add more rocks and more hands, you can. We just did this because it's small. 6 in total here. I think it looks pretty cool. And if you want to add like a rest in peace sign with it, you can. And sorry about that squeak, it's that darn wagon. Anyway, now to our next project. So next, you guys have probably seen this before, eyeballs in a bush. So my mom yesterday painted some eyeballs on some plastic pumpkins and just tried to nestle them in the bush. And it's supposed to be like a monster looking out at you. And I think that's good. There we go. So she painted them. I put a clear coat on them so if it rains or the paint won't wash off. And here's the finished product, eyeballs in a bush. And there's actually a skull that goes along with this, but I gotta finish painting that. And you'll actually see me paint that next. But first, we're going to take a look at the skeleton we got here. Just another cool thing we have. And also, you can't see him, so let me open the door here. We have spiders on the door. Sorry about the reflection of me and my mom, but spiders on the door. So, pretty cool. So, now I'm going to go inside. We're going to get this skull painted. Okay, so you might not know this about me, but when it comes to painting, I'm really good. So, we're going to go ahead and start painting. And now we are going to be clear coating the skull so if it does happen to rain, the paint will not wash off, because I'm pretty sure it would. So let's get started, shall we? Okay guys, it's been a couple minutes now since I've painted this. But the varnish is reacting with the paint. I've actually never seen this before. This is quite weird. But it just makes it look even creepier. So, yay! Okay guys, so this is just, my camera can't really focus because it's dark. But anyway, we added some lights inside of the skull. And you really can't see it up here, but there's some plastic up here that really isn't shining light very well, but doesn't that look really cool? Really eerie. So there you go. There's a skull. We'll just set it up later. Okay, and for this last one you'll need, what is this again?
Crepe paper.
Crepe paper and a balloon and some scotch tape. Basically, what we're doing here is a big spider in the corner of the room. Let's get started. Okay, so first you gotta inflate the balloon, of course.
Can you do it?
Oh, easy. And your spider doesn't have to be too big if you don't want to be. Is this good enough?
A little bigger.
Oh geez, this is when it becomes hard.
Okay.
There we go, and we have our spider's body. Okay, Now I gotta stick it up in the corner. Oh, someone's not tall enough. One moment, please.
You should be able to touch that.
Let's try this again. Do you want me to do it?
I'm going to put it.
Oh, jeez. There we go. Now, right now it just looks like a black balloon. Need any help there? Nope, you're good. Now it just looks like a black balloon, but now we're going to add some paper. Okay, guys, we just cut the crepe paper into strands. About how long are those?
4 feet.
4 feet? So, 4 feet strips of paper. You don't have to make them that long, and you don't have to make the balloon that big if you don't want them that big. You can make them smaller if you want to. But, we will, get set up and, we'll show you guys us putting them up. Be right back. The finished product. This boy is staring into your soul. Okay, guys, so we're gonna go ahead and start setting up some lights along this fence. Let's get to it. We are on our last project, skeleton in a chair. Just get a different handhold on this camera. Giant hunk of yarn. And we're going to tie the skeleton to the chair.
Skeletons and shivers down your spine. Shrieking skulls will shock your soul and seal your doom tonight. Spooky, scary skeletons speak with such a screech. You'll shake and shudder in surprise when you hear these zombies shriek.
We're so sorry, skeletons, you're so misunderstood. You only want to socialize,
but I don't think we should.
A spooky, scary skeleton shouts startling, shrilly screams. They'll sneak under sarcophagus and just won't leave you be. We'll be right back.